What is that?
This is a muskrat.
It's what?
It's muskrat.
Muskrat, that's roadkill.
It is good.
Why do you serve muskrat and what is it?
I'll show you, Robert, just hold on.
Are you for real?
Yes.
It's high in protein. It tastes very good. People love it.
So who catches these?
There are several trappers in the area.
So in this area, muskrat is in?
Yes, and we serve a lot of this.
It smells horrific.
Oh, it's good.
Hi there, my name is Ginny. I'm gonna be your server today.
Let me try with that meatloaf, chip beef.
Chip beef, top seller.
Yeah. I hate to try it, but I'm going to try
muskrat.
It. The muskrat. Let's try the muskrat.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is the muskrat.
I've eaten bull testicles. I've eaten a rattlesnake. I've eaten just about everything there is to eat on the face of the planet. But I have never had muskrat before. Very dark in color. It looks like it was fried. It's got a very strong odor. No meat on it. How do you eat this?
You have to pick it with your fingers.
Yeah, really. Okay.
And then they put the bones in this bowl.
Just tastes like old dead meat that has been crawling around in a swamp somewhere. It's almost like swimming roadkill. It's apparently a delicacy when it's seasoned, just not for me.
You do open for dinner one night, correct?
It's over now. It's Thursday night, January to March.
Why is that?
For my muskrat.
There's that thing again, that furry creature.
But so, that night makes me money.
Okay.
Patty, we have something we have to discuss, and that would be muskrat. Do we keep the muskrat on the menu? You know, there's a few kind of things we need to discuss here.
Okay.
So I wrote down some cons why I think it shouldn't be on the menu, and you wrote down some pros why it should be on the menu. So I think I should go first.
Okay.
And I'm gonna say why it shouldn't is because it has rat in its name.
Okay.
How many people do you know like to eat rats?
This has been going on for about 50 years, okay? Western staple.
I think, with all the bones, it's a choking hazard to your guest.
I never had anybody choke on them. And our locals around the area, it's a draw.
My problem is that it's seasonal.
My profits on that is $12.25. A dish.
Which is pretty high, right?
Yes.
My thing is, there's a deterrent for people coming in. It's a rat by name. It's got lots of bones in it. It's seasonal, and that might turn off a lot of people coming to your restaurant. This is your restaurant. What I'm going to say is, if you want to keep this on, that's your prerogative. But what I'm going to tell you, you have to get this thing from a valid supplier, somebody that you trust to give you safe product. Not some fly-by-night. It has to be taken from a valid supplier, okay?
Sure will.
I'm not going to include muskrat on tonight's menu because I want to show Patty that she doesn't need it to have a successful night. Well, you've made your argument. I've made mine. I'm going to leave mine there. So I've got to go back into the restaurant and get it finished, okay?
Okay.
All right. Thanks.
Thank you, Chef. Robert brought up a lot of valid points, but I held my own because we've been doing it here for so long that I really hate to get rid of it. So I will more than likely keep it on the menu.
Muskrat, muskrat, candlelight. Doing the town and doing it right in the evening. It's pretty pleasing. Muskrat Susie, Muskrat Sam, do the jitterbug out in Muskrat Land and they shimmy. Sam is so skinny, nibbling on bacon, chewing on cheese. Sam says to Susie, honey, would you please be my missus? voices. Susie says yes with the kisses. Any whirl, any twirl, any tangle, singing and jangling a jangle, floating like the heavens above, looks like muskrat love.
What is that?
The muskrat.
It's what?
It's muskrat.
Muskrat, that's roadkill.
Muskrat.
No way.